Suppose you've discovered a pattern, perhaps a relationship of cause and effect in geometry. A proof is just an explanation of factuality of a statement that you have. That's your result. Now, to get a proof, what you're looking for is to build a bridge for your audience. All right, so let's say this stream is the river of missing knowledge that we have to cross from our givens to our result. Well, we're allowed to build our series of stepping stones any way we like. We might just look for stepping stones that are near the givens, and other stones perhaps that are near the result. Stepping stones are facts and theorems that we know, and we'd like to connect them in order to get across. The proof, when it's written down, should be a nice route to take, a step at a time from our givens to our result. Here's an example. Say that we're supposed to show that given x, y, and z are numbers which are the angles of a triangle. Then we must show x plus y plus z, if they're in degrees, total to 180 degrees. All right, there's a lot of facts about triangles that we know, and a lot of facts about angles. Here's a few facts about angles and triangles and straight lines. One is that if you draw a straight line, then the angle made by thinking of it as two lines extending from a dot in the middle is 180 degrees. If their two lines cross, then the opposite angles in fact, we could use the same letter to denote both of those angles. If two parallel lines denoted by the little arrows showing that they're parallel cross a third straight line, then the two corresponding angles are equal. Again, we could just use the same letter to denote both of them. These are stepping stones, and you can imagine there may be a lot more stepping stones just by opening up your geometry book. Now, this top one is closer to your finish, since 180 degrees is what we're trying to show these angles sum to. The other two, we could try and start with either of them, but actually this one is closer to the beginning. So our proof is going to go in this order. All right, let me show you how that works on the original triangle. Okay, first, I can use the fact that those opposite angles are equal. This angle X is exactly the same as this angle. I'll call it X. And this angle Y is exactly the same as that angle. I'll call it Y. Now I'm going to use my second fact about corresponding angles. To do that, I'm going to have to add a line to my picture. Notice that I've already extended these lines a little bit to create the angles, the new angles, opposite to the original ones. Now I need an entirely new line. It's going to go through the point at which Z is the angle, and it's going to be parallel to the opposite side from Z. Now I have parallel lines, and first, I can note that this side of the triangle is a line crossing those parallel lines, so this angle is also X. Again, I can note that this side of the triangle is a straight line crossing parallel lines, so that this angle is Y. But now, look what's happened. I have three angles, X, Y, and Z, making up a full 180 degrees. So X plus Y plus Z equals 180.